Hello, and welcome to the Outpost Frequencies. The stupid Outpost Frequencies, which have been brought forward an hour because of a stupid daylight saving. Brought to you by thelastmovieoutpost.com for all of your movie news, reviews, and everything cool about film. Sorry.
Still noon here. I don't know what your problem is.
Wait, what noon? It's 1 p.m.
Same bat time, same bat channel.
No, it's 5 o'clock here now, and so I haven't had my dinner, and so I'm down very hungry. Usually I'm quite satisfied at this point, and this is why Matt is late, because I imagine he's eating his dinner and doesn't realise he will join us in an hour's time.
I think more likely he saw what we were talking about today and forgot that it was daylight saving time.
It's nice to have Sean back. How was jail? I mean, your camping trip. sorry, your camping trip.
Yeah. It was a lot of hard labor and tense showers.
A work camp is still a camping trip.
Yeah, that's right. We're outside in the woods working harder. Okie doke. And Yoda, how are you, mate?
Oh, I'm fantastic. I've got one less hour sleep. I'm sure this will go swimmingly. You've had no food. I'm tired. Everybody hates us,
Sean's
apparently.
Sean's back. Yeah, I know. We've had some comments on YouTube, haven't we? Goodness me. Three middle-aged white men moaning about everything in the world.
Do you want to talk about that? Because I wanted to bring it up.
Go for it. Have you got the comments there?
No, and I'm not going to go through them all because I got into it with one of them, and I tried to put my money where my mouth was. I said, okay, fine. You really got a problem with us? Why don't you come onto a stream? We'll talk about it. Of course, she saw it as, or he, I don't know, saw it as a trap. You're just going to come after it.
Give me some background because I've missed this.
Hang on. I'll find the comments. You carry on talking, Yoda. I'll find the comments.
Yeah. As usual, I take this stream and I cut it up into various, sections, right? And let me put a banner here so I know to add this one in a second.
Oh, yeah, well done.
There we go.
Hate mail. Maybe you should relabel that as hate mail.
Fan mail. Let's put it fan mail. Because apparently we got some fans out there. We talked about, you know, and I don't know how much if you old farts moaning about me. accurate. So I don't know if you watched any of the clips or anything, Sean, but we talked about the Peter Pan and Wendy trailer. Which is
the completely non-woke, looking forward to great remake, Happy Days, Peter Pan. Yeah,
right. So I mean, it's being downvoted into oblivion, and everybody's looking at this going, "Oh yeah,
I didn't see that."
Oh yeah. It's racial. What is it up to now?
No, wait. It's like 7 upvotes and 2 downvotes.
I don't mean... I'm talking about the trailer is being downvoted into oblivion.
Right.
So what did
I thought you meant us.
What did you two retards say about it while I was gone?
We said Sean is going to love it.
He likes movies about small children and their nightgowns. Is that too much? I think that's too much. Basically, we said kind of the usual stuff. You know, why is Disney doing this? What, you know, like the Critical Drinker kind of really nailed it because he understands what Peter Pan is all about and that Wendy is the influence that makes the boys grow up, because you know, in traditional society, women are the civilizing influence.
God, of course, get a job, pay your bills, stop throwing rocks at
tadpoles. But I mean, but
stop,
with it, the
stop,
original
stop putting
no
rockets
fun.
On your lawn tractor, no
yeah.
fun, yeah,
no
I know.
Fun,
yeah.
no fun.
I agree, but I mean, the original a certain element of that.
I was just gonna say that the original Peter Pan, there's a line in there that says that girls will never join the Lost Boys because girls are too clever. So it's quite a feminist story already, but then Hollywood has completely missed that subtlety.
No. Let me explain this to you because you're English and you're dumb. Back when that book
it's
was
an English story, for Christ's sake,
I know,
Sean.
I know it. That's why I'm gonna. That's why I called him dumb. He doesn't know that back then, clever was an English term for stupid woman.
Was it? Okay.
No, we still use the expression stupid woman over here. Really going to get downvoted.
I need some sources on that other than Wikipedia, Sean.
I'm editing the Wikipedia article right now about that.
According to Wikipedia that I just put in there.
We have just lost our one viewer.
I don't give a fuck.
Who cares?
But basically, we had somebody making comments saying three grown men getting upset about a Disney film, laughing face, grow up mentally.
No. Oh, God. I could have handled the comment, but with the emoji, that just, oof.
Can I make a small point to that? How many grown men do you think made the fucking movie? Okay.
Yeah, that's right. It's a bunch of kids. And you, Joe, Peter Pan, and all Joe will color them in. Yeah, you know, it's a lot of grown men.
I'm like, do you think that we might have some... Look, we are three guys in our late 40s, some of us in our early 50s, that are still arguing about fucking Star Wars and Star Trek, right? This stuff is influential. It matters. It influences the culture, and in sometimes very good ways. Did you see the trailer, Sean? Because I'm still trying to get to this, but...
No, I'm not going to watch that dog shit.
Okay, Phil keeps interrupting me, so I got to... this is give Phil shit day again. Wendy appears and she meets all the Lost Boys, and she says, but you're not all boys. And the two twin black girls go, so? I'm like, how ham-fisted do you got to get with your stupid message, you know? And it completely destroys what Peter Pan was all about. Rightly or wrongly, whether you like the story or not, that's what the story is about. And that the boys are there because they're boys. It's all about growing up, the civilizing influence of getting married, having children, all that kind of stuff. Even Hook understood this. And, you know, so... This is the message you're giving our children. These children are going to grow up. And unfortunately, the way she says it's like you're arguing about a children's movie. Do you turn 18 and does your brain just erase and all the stuff you watched as a kid just goes away and now you're only into adult stuff now? Does this have no influence on you as you get older?
Yeah.
This is all rhetorical, right? Because you know the real reason that this person made that comment.
Well, I know exactly why she made the comment, because as we argued back and forth, she brought up three white men. Okay, I got it. I was born wrong. She's a racist. She's just another leftist. I got to say this, too. Progressives is the worst name in the world, because these people are stuck in the 1940s where there were more racists and Nazis per capita than any other time in the human existence.
Man, I wish
I
could
wait for it. They want it so bad. I gotta fight the Nazis and the racists, and that's all I care about. We all moved on, assholes. Grow up.
You're making a compelling argument for me to invent a time machine so I can go back and live in the 1940s.
At least you have to Yoda, Nazis to fight.
I said to Yoda that I was quite happy to blackface, but apparently that's wrong as well.
Apparently.
It is? What about gay face? Is that a thing?
Is that a thing? How do you do that?
Well, there's woman face. That's Dylan, no beard. Whatever
so
his
wait,
name is.
When is woman face a... being trans and then as opposed to being offensive? I'm a little confused on.
Well, I'm pretty sure a dude running around in high heels in the hiking in the woods is pretty much.
There's a great meme. There's a great meme going around of somebody who was apparently matched up on her lesbian app like Tinder. And it was basically a bunch of blokes. And some of them were wearing dresses, but one of them was just a bloke in a shirt. And he was called Zachary. And I remember the comments were kind of like, Zachary's not even made an effort, is he? <You know? laughs> At least some of them tried to put on a dress and tried to look feminine. But like Zachary was just like, no, not having any of that. I'm just a lesbian.
It's ma'am.
And according to And according to their own rules now, that like they can't say anything back to him, you know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, of course, yeah. You can't have a go at him because, yeah, that's right. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's a catch-22, isn't it? Oh, cool, yeah. Dear.
They really painted themselves into a corner with that.
here's my motivation here. There's a part of me that, I mean, ever since Trump came down the fucking escalator in 2015 for the last 8 years, it's been nothing but snark back, you know, escalating obviously to obvious things. Nobody's talking to each other and nobody's figuring anything out and we're not getting anywhere. And I just as me as a person, no joke, no bullshit, I just feel like I'm just stuck in quicksand anymore with this culture and with the way the country's going. I'm tired of the arguing. I'm tired of the nonsense. I'm tired of the little you make these comments in bad faith, like we don't care, like we don't have children, like we don't care about what we're leaving to our children. How many times have I said, even on this podcast, what do my kids have to hold on to the way I have Star Trek and Star Wars and Lord of the Rings and so many other things? What do they have?
Do you know what? That's so weird you say that, because the other day I was talking to somebody, we mentioned Phase 4, and I had to really rack my brain to think what was in Phase 4 for Marvel. And I was like, there was the, Black Widow. Black Widow was one, wasn't it? And again, I was thinking like King Godzilla versus King Kong. How many people have referred back to that? It was one of the biggest movies that came out, but nobody's ever gone back and thought, oh, it's just a great film. Did you see King Kong?
I liked it. I talk about it all the time. What the fuck are you talking about? By the way, that far left SJW commenter is back in the comment section live now. I think I know who it was you were talking about, because she's obviously back.
Oh, great. Oh, goodness me. Here we go.
The communists of weekend, Yoda. Yeah, it's possible. I don't know. It's not so much weak. It's just bored more than anything.
Yeah.
It's like, when do we move forward? When do we? Isn't this the same thing we always talk about with, they always reboot movies. They don't break anything new. We don't, you know, it's not just the movies. I mean, it's all of culture. It just feels like we're just stagnated and we just don't move and we're just fighting each other in quicksand as we all sink.
Yoda, you got to take the accelerationist peel like me.
No, I'm close. I'm there. I think I'm there.
I'm really looking forward to Scream 7.
I don't think we're there yet.
I'm looking forward to Scream 7.
Mm.
You would be.
Yeah. I bet Cecil is, unironically.
Funny enough, I do know that he did like 5, but I mean, I'm just... I'm so bored of... Sorry.
I should have invited Cecil on for that. I know, she said... That's her on... She thinks that's very funny on Instagram to say that to me on every post. It's her. It's one of those things where, like, a woman comes up with it and she thinks it's funny. But, you know, as we all know, women have no, you know,
funny gene. Funny,
they have
funny
no
bone.
Objective way to tell what's actually funny or not without a man telling them it's funny.
Yeah. And obviously nobody's told her that it's
nobody's not. Told her because they think it's funny that she thinks it's funny. So
does Kamala Harris count? I know it's all unintentional with her, but it is pretty freaking hilarious.
No, being funny means you got to do it intentionally.
It's got to be on purpose. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I'll accept your rules.
What about Tina Fey?
No.
Oh, man, I like Thirty Rock.
You would.
It's got that lovely Alec Baldwin in it.
He is pretty cool. I got it. Yeah.
I loved it when he shot up the studio.
You know what? I rewatched.
Great episode.
They're going to be finishing Rust.
You know what? I rewatched Hunt for Red October 2 days ago, and he is. I hate to say this, but he's a great actor. He's made some great movies. You know, he is a good actor.
Well, we know he's a great actor because of what do you call it, Team America. He's one of the greatest actors in the world.
and the head of FAG.
Yeah.
That's no, he film actors guild to you. Yeah. Not even.
He really is. That's true. He did call a reporter a fag and shot a woman. That is pretty based. I gotta agree with Heidi on that. Her sense of humor is completely gone, but her sense of judgment on other things is impeccable.
Yeah, no, that is true. And yeah, because he accidentally shot a woman. So yeah.
Thank you for watching this excerpt from Outpost Frequencies. Tune in live every Sunday at noon Central Time or 6 o'clock UK time. And also, remember to come to lastmovieoutpost.com for all your latest in movie news, streaming news, and everything cool about film. We are the cool news now. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the next stream.